Hey guys, so one of the most important things with Glide is that whatever you see here on your builder and on your app when you share your app and get a link to your app is that whatever's appearing here is in a spreadsheet. So right now, the back end, the database, the information that we show in Glide is living in a Google sheet. So when you are setting up your app from your template, first you have to go over to your spreadsheet to see and to edit the data that you have there. In the templates, we have placeholder information for everything. But the most important thing about how the setup works in the spreadsheet is that we have named the columns the right way, right? So in this case, we have a column named image, and then we have links to images. We have in this case a column, which is a Boolean column, like a true or false column, called approved, and then it's a checkbox. Then we have mostly text columns, right? So when you are opening and editing your template, make sure that you go over your spreadsheet. So how do you open that? When you are here in your template in Glide, you click here the edit sheet pencil, and then it will open up a Google spreadsheet. This Google spreadsheet is already in your Google Drive. So it's not, you're not seeing somebody else's. It is your own spreadsheet, but you have to edit that and make sure that you make the appropriate changes. Now, what we see here in the spreadsheet, we can also see in Glide in the data editor. So if we look at this, we have this restaurant, then Purampoli, then Busman's Pizza. And then if I go over here, I see the same items, right? The same rows, the same amount of data that I have in my spreadsheet, I'll see that same thing over here in Glide data. Now, a very important thing is that you can see here the headers on the top of Glide. Their names, same names that I have in my spreadsheet, but Glide figures out what type of data is there. So in this case, we have a phone, cell phone, right? But Glide puts the phone icon because it knows it's a phone, right? We have the approved tab, which is a Boolean, which is true or false. So Glide knows it's a switch, it's or a checkbox, true or false. And then again, we have a date column that Glide knows it is date. Why? Because every single value in this column, except the header, of course, has a date. Or every single value here has a checkbox. Or every single value has a number. When you are editing your template, make sure that you don't change these kind of things. So you can delete the whole column or delete the whole row. You can edit the information that you have inside of each row, right? But the worst thing you can do is here in your spreadsheet, instead of having this true or false, you put text, because then Glide doesn't know which type of column is that. Is that text? Is that a checkbox? It doesn't know. Again, same thing here. It's a date format, but then if you start changing that, then it'll break how Glide sees that data. And then we need this setup so that Glide can do different things with the data. So the best way to add more columns, if you don't want to add more rows in your template, go over to your spreadsheet, click here, add 10 rows, then we have 10 blank rows, right? Actually, look, this is the wrong format. You will add 10 blank rows. If you want to add more columns, I would suggest doing that in Glide. And how will you do that? You will go all the way to the right, top right, add column, and then you will choose the right column type. So we have, on basic columns, we have text, number, date and time, image, link, phone number, email, Boolean, which is the true or false, rich text, and emojis. So if you want to have a new column for, in this case, the, let's say, the owner's email address, then we'll make it an email column. That way you can see Glide put the at on the name, and then we'll name it the right way. And then I click done. So Glide knows that that column has only emails. And that way, now if you want to go back to your spreadsheet, you will see the email column here. It's empty on both Glide and the spreadsheet. But Glide already knows you will have emails here. So make sure that you open your spreadsheet and edit the information that you have there the right way.